fish friends, how's it going? Hope you're doing well. My name is Zenzo with Tazawa Tanks. I get a lot of questions about how I set up my brackish tank and how to take care of it, so I thought I would kind of explain what brackish water is and how I care for the brackish water that houses the mudskippers and the figure eight puffer. So first things first, let's talk about the puffer. A lot of you had names for the puffer, some great names out there, some ones that really made me kind of scratch my head and think, should I name it this or should I stick with that? Ultimately, the puffer decided what its name is. The name of the puffer is Poe. Now, I didn't really think about it at the time, and I didn't really notice the markings on the back of the figure eight puffer. I was more concerned with making sure that its fins were healing and that it was eating properly and that it looked in good health. I didn't really look at the patterns on its back. Well, a lot of you wrote to me in comments and said, the name of the puffer is on the back of the puffer. If you look at it very closely, it actually spells out Poe. P-O. So the top of the top design is a P and the second design in the middle is an O. Now some of you kind of came up with some other letters for the third letter, but for me the P-O was very, very prominent, easy to see. And soon as I saw that, I said, Zenzo, you're kind of a dummy. You should have saw that from the very beginning. So anyway, his name is Poe. For those of you that commented on my video giving suggestions for the puffer's name, for those of you that mentioned Poe and pointed that out, thank you very much. Now, a lot of you also mentioned Shemp. So as we know, I have the three mudskippers and they are called Larry, Curly, and Mo. They were named by my wife the first time she saw them because they kind of are goofy. So the three stooges. And a lot of you said that I should name the puffer Shemp because of the original, the four original Three Stooges and kind of the brother that was kind of filling in, etc. But anyway, for those of you that understand, you know, what happened with my original order and getting another mudskipper and that whole dilemma, I ultimately decided to name the new mudskipper Shemp. Shemp is not in the brackish tank yet. He is in his own little small quarantine system just because I want him to fully kind of recover from the ordeal that he went through. I want to put on some weight. He's been eating mealworms. He's been eating baby crickets. He's been eating bloodworms. He's been eating freeze-dried brine shrimp. He's been eating flightless fruit flies. So he's been eating a lot and doing very well. But he is smaller than these other guys, so I want to give him a chance to really put on some size and some mass gains before he goes in here and has to deal with these three. So now I'm going to talk a little bit about how to care for the tank. The first thing I'm going to do is address some of the questions that a lot of you guys had as far as how I set it up. A lot of you asked about the top. Am I worried about the mudskippers jumping out? No, I'm not, because I have custom tight-fitting lids that don't allow anything to get through them. I made those out of acrylic panels. Secondly, a lot of you had mentioned the depth of the beach on this end of the brackish tank and asked me, am I worried about the buildup of anaerobic bacteria and the release of gases that could be harmful to the fish? Well, not necessarily. If you did watch the original video that I filmed, you know, several weeks ago, a couple months ago by now, you would have seen that when I built this, the majority of this space is taken up with concrete blocks and expanding foam. So I laid down a bed of sand. I put the blocks on top of the sand so that the concrete blocks are not in contact with the glass. And those concrete blocks are filled with expanding foam. So they take up the majority of the volume. And then just on the kind of the edge here, there's sand on the very edge and then obviously the cracks. But overall, the entire depth of the beach in most areas is only around 3 to 4 inches at the top. So really not concerned about that. The other thing is because this, if it did gas off, it would gas off into the tank itself and then be able to escape through the little holes in the lid. It's not like it's getting dissolved into the water that they are living in. So what is brackish water? A lot of you don't know what brackish water is, or you have, you know, kind of some questions and concerns about possibly setting up your own system. I can tell you that it's very easy. All that brackish water is, it's a mixture of fresh water and seawater. So usually it's like in an estuary, it's at the mouth of a river where, you know, a river is flowing through, you know, land and it meets the ocean and it mixes and you have kind of a mixture of salinity. So basically brackish water is any fresh water that has elevated levels of salinity, meaning salt in the water. So typically you're going to see anywhere from like 1.005 to 1.010 on the salinity scale as far as specific gravity for brackish water. However, technically, I guess you could say it's anywhere from like 1.003 to right around 1.015. When you get above 1.015, you start to get into higher salinity levels, and that really is more for marine type environments. With my tank, I keep it right around 1.007 to 1.008. If you don't know what that means, essentially when you add salt, it changes the gravity of the water, the specific gravity of the water. For example, if you go out swimming in the ocean, you may notice that when you get tired and you kind of rest, you don't sink as quickly as you would like in a lake or a swimming pool or a pond because you're more buoyant. Salt in the water changes the specific gravity and keeps you a little bit more buoyant, and you can measure that with different tools. There's a couple of ways of measuring salinity of water. I use the refractometer. It's a little bit more accurate. It's pretty easy to use. You just have to make sure that you have a decent one and that you calibrate it. I use this for my service business when I do saltwater tanks. And another tool that's a little bit less expensive, or a lot less expensive, and also relatively easy to use once you kind of get the hang of it, is using a hydrometer or a hydrometer, however you want to say it, hydrometer or hydrometer. Either way, potato, potato, it does the same thing. You would submerge this into the water, and then the little needle, the arrow, would kind of float up and tell you the specific gravity of the water that you're testing. As far as mixing the water, it's really easy. All you need to do is buy your favorite marine salt or reef salt that you get at your local fish store, and then mix up the salt water following the instructions that's on the bag. Once you've done that, you can then measure that salt water to see if it's at the right level. Usually that's anywhere between 1.022 to 1.025. Once you've done that, you just need to mix that salt water with some fresh water. Now, depending on the salinity that you want your brackish tank to be, and depending on the fish that you're keeping, is going to determine how much freshwater to saltwater mixture you have. For me, I've kind of played around with it, trying to find the best system. Ultimately, what I found is I've been doing right around a quarter to a third or so of saltwater to, you know, two-thirds to three-quarters of freshwater. What I'll do is I will, you know, mix up some saltwater. I'll let it, you know, make sure that's fully dissolved. Usually what I like to do is kind of do it a few days in advance so that that saltwater is fully dissolved. And then when I'm doing a water change, I'll add some saltwater, I'll add some freshwater, and about halfway through, I'll measure the salinity and then adjust accordingly. So it's really not that difficult. You know, once you get the hang of it, it doesn't take that much longer than it does, you know, doing a water change on a freshwater tank. You just have one extra step of making some salt water in advance and then mixing the two. Everything else is the same. You're going to use your same dechlorinators and everything else that you might add to your tank to care for the fish. As far as feeding, I've talked about this in the past. The mudskippers do have a healthy diet. They love to eat, so they do have a healthy appetite as well. So they are getting all the foods that I'm feeding shrimp, the live crickets, the mealworms, the bloodworms, you know, mysis shrimp, etc. I do try to mix it up. I was giving them pellet food, but ultimately I decided not to give them pellet food. I like these little guys. They're kind of like my special little pets. So I'm kind of focusing more on freeze-dried foods, frozen foods, and then once in a while some live foods. As far as Poe, he is also getting very similar diet. He doesn't eat the mysis shrimp, but he does eat snails. He will eat mealworms, he will eat bloodworms, and kind of anything else that I go put in there that will sink. So that's about it. It's really not that difficult to take care of a brackish system. Just make sure that you do your homework, do your research, and understand the fish that you're keeping and how they need to be kept. And then start learning how to measure salinity, get yourself a hydrometer or get yourself a refractometer so that you can start making some salt water. Mix that with fresh water and you're all set. Hopefully this video was useful for those of you that have talked about getting mudskippers and, you know, I've had questions about it. I will put down in the comments below where I got my mudskippers, the good ones. A lot of you in the other video had, you know, mentioned that I really do need to share with you guys where I got shemp from, and to warn all of you not to buy from that company. Well, for a couple of reasons, I can't do that. I actually did talk to an attorney. Some of you claimed that I didn't. There were some comments that claimed that I didn't talk to one. I actually did. I actually called a friend of mine who is an attorney, and I asked her specific questions about the video and about the whole circumstance, and I was advised to not disclose directly If people comment or if they want to reach out to me individually, that's fine. But not that I did anything wrong, and I didn't. She said, you know, I have all the proof. If it did go to court, I would win, but it's not worth the hassle. So anyway, if you do want to know, it's in the comments. I did pin the comment of who that company was, so I'm not going to go there. But anyway, if you are interested in getting mudskippers, I will put where these ones came from. And if you have any questions, please put it down below in the comments. As always, thanks for watching. I really appreciate your viewership. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. That helps the channel. Let's see if we can get, 1,000 likes on this one. We'll catch you on the next one.